And still on this matter of geomaritime and global stability and the future of global stability, we will now have a discussion with our very own National Resilience Institute Governor, Bapak Adi Wijayanto, that is right now in the studio, that will be giving an exclusive interview before the event at tomorrow of the 6th Jakarta Geopolitical Forum Geomaritime, Chasing the Future of Global Stability, that will commence tomorrow. Bapak, sebelumnya izinkan kami juga untuk melepas masker. So we like to ask Bapak Andi and also Rory and also myself. We will conduct this interview without any mask because we already have our booster shots.
Exactly, we've got our third shot, and we'd like to ask your permission for us to open our mask. Hopefully, you don't mind about that. Mm-hmm. Let's now move to the first question to Bapak Andi.
Yes, Bapak Andi. Again, as we stated before, that the 6th Jakarta Geopolitical Forum, Geomaritime, which this year's theme is changing the future of global stability. What is the agenda and also the initiative, especially for the 6th? Form of this year, Pak?
Yeah, first of all, we try to strengthen Lemhanas, National Resilience Institute mandate. When Lemhanas established by President Sukarno back in 1965, our mandate is to become Indonesian School of Geopolitics. Mm-hmm. So we have to prepare the future leader, our national leader, that aware on the impact of big power competition in our regional area. This year we are going to focus on geomaritime because we realize now in term of geopolitical struggle, we enter the fourth phase of geomaritime. And the first one was back in 16 until 18 century competition between Portugal, Spain and the Dutch. The second competition was in the 1819 until the early of 20th century when we acknowledge that the British rule the waves. Mm-hmm. Yeah, after that we saw the coming of US as the only sea power in the world, as the only hegemonic power in term of maritime projection. Now we are in the fourth era. In this era, the competition is not solely related to naval projection anymore, to military projection anymore, but more related, for example, to the issue of freedom of navigation, the issue of connectivity, the issue of global supply chain. So for this Jakarta Geopolitical Forum, our sixth event, we are focusing on geomaritime, we are focusing on identifying new challenges of maritime security, maritime stability for the next 10 years.
I think the forum is very timely because, as Pak Andi said, we are entering the fourth phase, right? And we're not only seeing a conflict between Russia and Ukraine nowadays, but a potential conflict between China and Taiwan, and it involves South China Sea as well, where Indonesia is part of. So how do you explain about the current situation nowadays when it comes to geopolitics, especially in South China Sea area? Is it unstable right now? Are ASEAN countries have to increase their naval protection or naval defense, for example? How do you see it?
I think in international relation term, now we are at the phase of rising tension that can lead to great power rivalry in our region. But what worry us right now is we see the strong indication that we are going to have an overlapping conflict. We still have the classical conflict of border. We still have problem of South China Sea dispute between six countries in this area. And another type of conflict is the classical geopolitical conflict between China and Taiwan, in issue of unification. Mm-hmm. but at the same time, we see the potential future conflict of connectivity. Mm. Yeah, because when Pelosi visited Taiwan, China launched a very massive military drill that basically blockade all possible navigation route from east to west, from north to south of Taiwan. So the problem of connectivity is clearly there when China conducted military drill maybe three weeks ago.
Yeah, and again, if we're seeing what is the the global standstill right now, we're seeing that there's the ongoing war, not only the European countries, we're seeing also right here in Asia and also the Asia Pacific itself. But in regards to your sixth event and you choosing the future of global stability, what is it like that you like to cater actually the message through the theme of the event of this year?
Yeah, three things actually.
Yeah.
The first one, realizing that we are now in the era of new geopolitics. Yeah, of geopolitics of connectivity, geopolitics of infrastructure, global infrastructure, and also geopolitics of global supply chain. We have two competing mega projects.
Yeah.
Yeah, the first one is the Belt and Road Initiative of Beijing. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that the first mega project. The second one is the mega project of Indo-Pacific Economic Framework of Indo-Pacific launched by President Biden November 2021. Yeah, I think this week US President Biden launched another project. They call it as the Global Supply Chain Resilience. So now the world has to choose between the magic word of supply chain belong to US with another magic word of infrastructure belong to China. Yeah, we Indonesia try to provide as usual the third way, to balance the competition between China and US. Yeah. In 2014, Pak Jokowi initiate the Global Maritime Fulcrum Doctrine. Yeah, but we are not in the position to offer a kind of regional or even global infrastructure project. So we still focus on our internal infrastructure project. Hopefully, by using this Global Maritime Fulcrum Doctrine, yeah, we can encourage other countries, yeah, especially such as India, South Africa, Brazil, Argentina, or even Mexico and Chile, yeah, to launch similar project. So we try to create a multiple regional mega project in term of creating infrastructure, supply chain, and also connectivity.
Wow. So talking about the theme that you mentioned earlier, so there are three themes. It's about defense, maritime defense and security in dynamic uncertainties. Number two is economy, geomaritime political economy, generating growth, sustaining resource and gaining power. And last but not least is about technology, advancing maritime technology in geostrategic context. So this theme is quite massive for a forum like this in Jakarta. Who are you inviting, sir? And what is actually the target and also the expected output from inviting these invitees?
Geopolitical Forum is an international conference, international seminar. So for this year, we invited experts from Russia, from US, from Singapore, and also from Australia. Their background are scholar from university or from academic think tank. From Indonesia, we also invited scholar and practitioner. For example, we invited Admiral Marsetio, used to be our chief of Navy. He will present his paper tomorrow, I think. And then we also invited Philip Vermonte from CSIS, Professor Tirta from BINUS University.
China will not participate.
For this year, no. yeah, mm. for this year now, because we really want to focus on the global arena, not only for East Asia. So we are really interested in grasping the insight from major player like US, Russia, and also Australia in term of global projection.
All right, it's going to be really interesting to talk more about it, yes. Carol, but we have to take a break for now, and we'll be right back with the second segment of the discussion with the Governor of National Resilience Institute. So please stay with us.